Hello, my friends. Today I'm going to give you a compare and contrast, and just show you all the leather bags that I have from Vera Bradley. I believe I did in a detailed review of each of them. I will make sure that link them down below. But in this video, instead of giving detailed review, the main goal of this video is really to compare these purses with and show you how they in terms of size wise and the structure wise, how they are different or from each other. So all together, as you can see, I lined them all up right here. I have four of them together. Let me start with the one that I'm using currently. Is this one, and this is a angled bowler. Okay, so in black leather, all of them are leather, and price wise they're extremely reasonable compared with any other those high-end purses. I think the price is extremely reasonable and very durable, especially this leather. I've been using this one for quite a while, at least a few months, and pretty consistently recently, and also I think last winter probably. So I've been using this a lot because it's a black. You don't really see any wear and tear. As you can see, it seems still quite, looks still quite new, quite nice. And because of this is, I think this is my first purchase, and because how much I enjoy the quality, and there are feet underneath, how much I enjoy the quality and the usability of this style. I actually went ahead and bought another one. These two are twins, identical. The only difference is the color. So I use this a bit more often during the summer, and these will use this more often during the fall, during the winter season. Okay, I'm looking very carefully in terms of wears and tears, anything like that. I don't really see anything. So these two are absolutely identical, and I usually just leave the purse open instead of zip it up. And let me zip it up and show you how they look like in terms of wear. So this one, the handle drop is very nice. It's very easy for you to put it over your elbow this way. Instead, this is another purse I have. This is called Mini Stella. It's very nice. As you can see, most of my purses are top handled. I really like top handle. It's my style. But this one, the handle drop is not large enough for you to be comfortably put your arms in and out, because sometimes with the coat, sometimes you want to be able to just carry it this way so you can have your hands free. This is much easier. This one's a little bit difficult. You have to hold it with the top, hold it like this, or you carry it with the shoulder strap. So that's the difference, main difference in terms of top handle drop. These two very comfortable. And the four Number four, the fourth one I have is this one. This is Quilt Emma Satchel. Okay, Quilt Emma Satchel. The handle drop is also good drop. Okay, good drop, easy to get in and out. So that's about the handle drops, and I really like this handle drop. During the weekends, I usually use my Louis Vuitton Speedy 30. That handle drop is just not, it's a little bit shorter. So, but this one's very comfortable. I can even put, now it's a little bit hard. Over the shoulder, it would be hard. I would consider almost impossible. Although I gained some weight, but unless you are very slim, you probably can do it that way. The shoulder strap, the setting I have is the shortest setting. Okay, let me show you. I am 5'5", so it's hit right over here. Okay, carry it with the shoulder strap. I think it's quite comfortable. You don't feel this one like bulky up or uncomfortable, and as you can see the handle would fell off nicely like that. I think it looks quite elegant. You can also obviously do crossbody. Again, this is set at the shortest setting, so look a little bit awkward, but if you extend it, I think it's absolutely no problem. Even with my big belly right now. So let me show you the other one as well. This is the blue one. I have it as the shortest setting as well. So I'm not going to do the crossbody demonstration. And my Mini Stella, this one's the setting, also the shortest setting. For some reason, Mini Stella's the shoulder strap, but this one's longer than the Mini Bowler, as you can see, even though both of them set at the shortest setting. Okay, I usually hold it like this. Okay, and then do crossbody. This one you can feel a little bit bulky because I think the width wise, the depth wise is larger than the other one. And the last one is Emma. This is, checking my notes here. This is Quilt Emma. The shortest setting, again, a little bit longer than the bowler. Okay, a little bit longer than the bowler. Crossbody. Okay. Feeling wise, I think the crossbody, the way I feel is very similar to Mini Stella. It feels a little bit bulky. Could be due to the quilting of the material that makes you feel a little bit puffy, kind of. And top handle, holding it with the handle. Okay. All right. Color wise, I use this mainly, I think this is a great color for winter purse. This one, I think it's all season, it's neutral. I feel it's all season. I use this a lot during the summer, last winter, and let me check the wear and tear, any color transferring, because this considers a pretty light color. I don't see any wear and tear, any color transferring. All these gold plates are, all these hardware are gold plates, which means it's very, the color will not fade. It's very, very durable. And you all see the very brightly engraved everywhere. And yeah, so still look quite nice, isn't it? Okay, so among these four of these, the one that I use the most, I would have to say probably is this one. And then it's this one. I haven't been using Emma too much, but it's nice to have, you know, something different that I can switch to, because I think you all probably feel the same, that after using the same purse a while, you feel like switching them. So in terms of durability, they are absolutely amazing, amazing, amazing quality. So if you have a chance, like right now, you know, if they have sale and the prices you feel it's right, I highly recommend, highly, highly recommend them. They are, most of them, these are all on sale. I bought them all on sale and the price is extremely reasonable. Next, I just want to show you how much they can hold and give you a brief overview of how much they can hold. So I'm currently using this one. Let me sit back a little bit. This is angle bowler. Okay, zip it. Maybe this works better. Oops. Okay, so inside, I have, by the way, I have a review already, so I'm not going to go too crazy about. I'm just show you, usually I will put a pair of gloves, agenda, wallet, another agenda, headset, lotion, pen, and a lips stuff. And I also use this the I also have a review of this thermal. I usually put that in, and also I want to show you my film. Yeah, the film. iPhone 8 Plus. There are two sleep pockets inside. Okay. Two sleep pockets inside. The phone can slide in. This way probably better. Can slide in. In both of them. A little bit snug, but a little bit tight, but they can definitely fit in. Okay. And the back pocket. There's a zip back pocket. Let me show you how the phone can fit in. If it can fit. I never tried to put iPhone. It's difficult. I don't want to force it. So I think the back pocket is good for if you have a very small wallet. Like I used two wallets. This one is the one with the keys and the cards. I usually take this one and my phone out just like that. This one has more other stuff, checkbooks, things like that. So I keep it in my purse. But if you have something small, it can slide in easily. No problem. Okay. So the purse can hold all this stuff easily. Okay, easily. And I can zip it easily. And it doesn't change the shape or anything. It looks beautiful. But most of the time, I do bring my coffee travel mug with me. So I would just put it on top. And instead of, and I don't zip it. And I carry it like this. Alright. So this is angle bowler. I'm not going to do the same demonstration for this one because they are just color difference. But let me show you. All this stuff can actually fit in this mini Stella. This is amazing. Mini Stella is just, I don't understand. It's so crazy. Probably because of the depth of it, that it can hold a lot. It can hold a lot. So the same stuff. Okay. Let me just load them in. My phone. My wallet. All right, now it's about this full, and then on top is my travel mug, and now here comes the magic. Okay. Here comes the magic. Look at that, it fits. I can even zip it. Isn't that crazy? And when I put the same amount of stuff in this angle bowler, I can't zip it. So this is amazing, Mini Stella. Don't overlook the size. It's just, it can span because of the depth. And also, it has that, it's not as structured as this one, even though both of them are quite structural kind of looking. But this one can really expand like crazy. So, so that's it. That's that. And last one is our Emma satchel. Wait, hey, let me sit down now. Emma satchel. This one, it seems like it's large, right? It seems it's the largest in terms of, you know, from the look, it seems like this is the largest one, Emma satchel. But it doesn't hold that much though. So go figure. I think it's just different kind of style, but in terms of holding things, they hold pretty much similar amount of stuff. I have some dust bag inside, but this one has a zip compartment on top. Okay, so let me just put all the stuff back in and show you how they look, how this one look. If I want to carry same amount of things inside this way, okay, and see if I can zip it. Okay, so everything's in now. Okay, this one, it looks, I think it looks fine, and it does look a little bit stuffed, but the shape still remains the same, right? That's everything inside, and it's a little bit heavy, this one, but there you go. It holds on everything comfortably. Okay. All right, that's all. That's all I like to show you. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave your comments down below. And if you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up. And I'll see you next time. All right, goodbye, my friends.